Yo guys, what is going on? It is Numb Next to bring you guys some more Pokemon Yellow. So in the last episode, we left off at Vermilion City. Didn't do much. I got the bike off screen. I also put Adam in the whatever it's called, the box where you train him up, the old man, right? Right, the old man? Where he trains you, the guy who trains you and shit, but now we're actually gonna take on the SS Aang because we need to get cut. And we can't really take on Vermilion City's very own Gemsaka. So I noticed a lady here who healed you. Maybe she's in this one, I don't know, but I'm gonna try and post-narrate this as much as I can. Mainly because I was doing this in Audacity. I'm like, okay, sweet, I got it done, great. New episode up, but then I'm like, I don't know. Like, I had it done, but then, you know, it just, Audacity did not want to cooperate, so again, it's not that bad. It might be a little bit unsynced, but again, otherwise, it really will not be that bad. So, yeah, guys, yeah. So, we're just, there's no healing up lady in here, so you actually have to go all the way back to the Pokemon Center and heal up, which is just ridiculous. Like, you learn so much in Yellow. I would have figured there was a healing lady in here, but no. No, there's no healing lady in here. There's no healing lady in here. If you guys saw, If you guys also witnessed Nappy's Omegle and witnessed a Mickey Mouse, that was actually me. I wasn't lying when I said that wasn't me. That was legitimately me. That was legitimately me. We're gonna take on every trainer here. Nidoran dies to a few hits. One more gust. Bop. There you go. Alright, so we got poisoned. But I came prepared. Antidote. I came very, very prepared. Just antidote bop him. That lady we can fight, she's got a Pidgey. Very not well trained. Nidoran female. Very not well trained. Put up a good fight and you're dead. So that item is TMO8. I'm wondering what that is. I think it's like Bubble Beam? It's Body Slam. That could be useful. Body Slam is very useful. Because I know in Gen 1, Body Slam is a higher percentage chance to paralyze. I know that. Or it might still be 30. It might just be 30 naturally. I know it's like 10%, but in this game it might be 30 because I swear to God, every time when I go for it in Gen 1, it just paralyzes you right away. But we're gonna go take on all the sailors because they're very weak and Pidgeotto needs some training. So look at that Tentacool, man. Alright, next guy, Machop. You died with 3 hits. Wow, that is disappointing. Shellder, thank God I didn't have the Aurora Beam. Get the crit and you die. So we have potions to heal up, and that's exactly what we are going to do. So now we're fully healed and rested. Whew! We can take on Gary right now. We can definitely take on Gary right now. So that is the plan of this. So, bonjour, Troy. Ho ho ho, imagine you sitting here. Ho ho, Troy, were you really invited? Ho ho. See the Pokédex coming. Ho ho. Ho 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 ho. I'm already caught 4D. Ho ho. Okay, I'm done. So he still has this really ugly looking Spearow. I don't know why he didn't evolve it. That thing dies. That thing dies. Never pull out. We're reloading. We're not pulling out. I can't use Meth because Meth is really weak. I didn't train up Meth or Charmander. I don't know why, but I wanted to catch a Magmar in this game because it's Tiduc, but I can't because Yellow you can't capture Magmar. But Eevee, we're not going to pull out. Hardy's too strong. Hardy's way too strong. Forget the Sand Attack. You still die. Alright, 1300 from this bad boy. I heard there was cut masterboard on board. Alright, so we get cut from this guy now. All we have to do is rub his delicate belly. Oh, I feel hideous. Urgh, seasick. Rub-a-dub-dub. Rub-a-dub-dub. Whew. Thank you. I feel much better. You want to see my cut technique? So he's very ill and cannot show us, but you know, since he's very an ill rapper, the illest out there, he's gonna show us, and instead of showing us, he just gave it to us. So, for some reason, I'm out of breath, but we have cut. We have cut now. We can actually take on the one and only Vermilion City's gym now. But you know, the yellow is yellow. So we're actually gonna try and get out of here. The speeding up, and we're gonna listen to this boat as it curves off. All right, what a lovely boat. That boat is so sad when it leaves. Like the feels just drop everywhere when that boat leaves. Oh my lord. But Hardy's too strong. Hardy, you guys are really something else. You guys legit came up with some chronological pattern with my nicknames. I didn't even notice it right now. J Hardy Pause Meth Good Bed, something like that. I don't even remember, but I don't know how you guys can do that. Your thought process is way better than mine. I can't even come up with something like that. But you know, in this game, you actually have to click on the Pokemon and use your HM, which is a little bit unfortunate, but you know, it's so well. So, first time around, we find it. All right, is it next door? God damn it. Now it's reset, but we're just gonna take on all the trainers because why not? As we're just gonna keep going for T-Bolt and knocking him out. But I wanna lead off with Paws. You know, I wanna evolve him. I don't know what level he evolves at. Maybe it's like 25. I feel like it's like 25 or soon. But he's just destroying everybody right now. He almost dies because Sonic Boom is OP in this game because it does 20 hit points. And at this time around, you really don't have that much HP. We found the switch. Maybe is it the one below? All right, I literally clapped my hands together so hard that the pain, but that I love that. I always struggle with this gym, but do I want to go back to the Pokemon Center? No, I just healed up like that. Forget it. We'll just take him on right now. He doesn't even have like three Pokemon in this game. He has a Raichu, level 26, 24. 24, 26 range. That's all he has because he goes to freaking war with his Pokemon. This man is hardcore. Ten Hun, welcome to Vermilion Gym. We look at that, a pint-sized challenger. Hello? We're gonna be destroying you, big-sized gym leader. We're gonna take him right now with his level 28 Raichu. Right, he goes to the X speed, two hits, we knock him out. That was pathetic. You were literally all talk. That was pathetic. Was that about destroying us, Lieutenant Surge? Whoa, I would be shocked too, man. He got popped. The real deal, kid. Hell yeah, man! Hell yeah! We are the real deal. Find and take the Thunder Badge.
As proof of your victory, a Thunder Badge.
Sandslash. That was really deserved. We needed that. Sandslash actually, Sandshrew actually deserved that. With all of that he did, he destroyed a level 28 Raichu without even being touched. He deserves that. But now we can use Fly outside of battle. Our speed gets cranked up, and he gives us Thunderbolt. So you already know then that if we ever lose Pikachu, which I'm trying not to, but if we ever lose Pikachu, we can teach Thunderbolt to Electabuzz or some other electric type, Magneton. Another Pikachu, maybe? No, you can't find Pikachu. Or maybe you can, I don't know. I don't know. I never thought about it that way. But now we can get a Squirtle. So I'm not sure if I want to keep the Squirtle on my team. We're gonna talk to you. The Thunder Badge? I just caught a Squirtle. We just got a Squirtle. Alright, so we're gonna name. I don't know what to name this Squirtle. But if I'm thinking interesting, I will call him Lube. Because Squirtle looks like Lube with a shell. So we're gonna put him in the PC, which is great, because I'm not gonna use him right away yet, though I do need a water type. So if you guys could recommend who I should remove off my team, I feel like it should be either Hardy or Bulbasaur, because I don't need a grass type. We have Hardy. And if I do want Bulbasaur, then we don't need Hardy. But then again, Hardy's done a lot of work. Bulbasaur is really weak. Do I really wanna take him? Like, do I really want to? Do I legitimately want to? I'm not too sure, but we are gonna be moving on with our journey right now. So I know we have to go get Flash, which is the next opportunity thing to get into Lavender Town. So we're gonna go inside of there, but first we're gonna buy some repels because I do not want to find loads of Diglets and Trios like chasing me around. So we're gonna buy a few repels. I think five is good. We're good to go. So gonna put on the repel right now, and I think I should be good. So right away we run into a Dugtrio, and I'm just gonna kill it off, get that delicious EXP, two crits in a row. But I found a Dugtrio right away. That is incredible. We got out of there unscathed, and is that the word? Scathed? Scathed? I don't know if that's a word. Unscathed? I'm not sure. But we ran out of repel, And now we can talk to the scientists. And do we have 10 Pokemon? I feel like we don't. 15! Alright, I don't even know we had 15. But now we're gonna use Cut. If I had an Abra that I found outside of Vermilion, before I got here, I would have easily triggered it for Mr. Mime, because Alakazam is too mainstream and OP, and I'm more of a Mr. Mime kind of guy. I like Mr. Mime. Mr. Mime is very creepy. We can't escape. What is going on? We're taking damage. What? Wait, what? Alright, okay, good. We switched out, alright, because I did not want to die too soon there, and we're not switching out, like, literally, I know they don't have Arena Trap, but again, I guess you have to be faster than them, and Diglett and Dugtrio are, like, really, really, really fast, surprisingly. Like, they are very fast. I know Dugtrio is, like, base 120 speed, so it's very, very, very fast, but we have a Sandshrew on our team. You guys do want me to remove him, but I can't do that, guys. We need a ground type. And, you know, ground types are actually very strong in this generation. Very, very, very strong. And I just had a fly that just smacked me in the face and just flew. My god. My god. But, we're gonna continue on with this, and Sandshrew is basically gonna destroy his arch nemesis of his grass types. And we're gonna pick up this item, and that item turned out to be TM30. I have absolutely no idea what TM30 is. Maybe it's good, maybe it's bad. We're gonna take on this guy right here, go for Slash. This crit ratio on Slash is ridiculous. I swear to God, every time you hit it, it will go over like a critical hit. I think Gen 1 runs like that. I know Gen 1 is very weird when it came to competitive battling and stuff, but then again, no one really cared. People just used moves, regardless of even typing. People just used moves. We were all Ash. At one point in our lives, we were all Ash, and we all just did stupid stuff in Gen 1. So, I could capture something there, but I'd rather wait and go up ahead, see what I find there. Poor guy, I just destroyed all of his bug Pokemon. I just killed them all. And I'm going to destroy this guy's ground types. Machop, you die. Geodude, you die. I know ground moves are physical in this game, so we are safe. Because Sand Slash is actually a very good physical Pokemon. Physical attacker. So, we find a Nidoran female. Hopefully we can capture this. And we only have one Pokeball left. We have to use it wisely. So, I don't know if it can take another scratch. We'll come with the Pikachu T-Wave. Hopefully we catch it. Why, you're a bitch. Forget you. I actually kind of wanted a Nidoqueen just in case Sandslash dies, but you know what? Forget you. So we need to teach somebody Flash, and I think right now Pikachu is the best bet. Oh, Hardy can learn it too. Sweet. So we'll get rid of... I probably should have gotten rid of Tackle, but I got rid of Poison Powder instead. I don't know. So, Zubat, we ran away. I don't know why, but we ran away, so I can't find anything in this cave anymore. Or no, we ran away because Dupe's Claws, yeah. Alright, because Zubat is easily in the Dupe's Claws section, so... Yeah, that's pretty much it. Zubat is easily in the Dupe's Claws section, so I will not be finding or catching any Pokemon that I've seen slash catch owned. So, pretty much right now, I think Sandslash is second strongest, if I'm not mistaken. 27. We don't need Poison Sting, and that Bulbasaur just dies to our fangs. He has huge claws. If he goes for Slash... If I'm almost guaranteed, he's the first Pokemon that has ever learned Slash. The very first Pokemon who's ever learned Slash. Because it is his in his name, in his claws. But, enough with the fun facts, we just dodged that self-destruct underground. Underground. That is ridiculous. But, I feel like we should take on every trainer in here. So, she has a Jigglypuff, we'll go for Slash. Slash, Slash, and you all die. Level 28. He's really getting close to Pikachu now. Dig, because I know this guy is self-destruct. Dig, and he goes for self-destruct, and we're hiding underground. So, legitimately, we're safe. I want to battle this guy. I want to gain as much EXP as possible. And the Slash right now is ridiculous. I don't know if you guys wanted me to do Mew. I don't want to do Mew, to be honest. It's too much work, you know? It is way... I mean, I might do it as a bonus episode, but other than that, it is way too much work. It's legit way too much work, but still so much Dupe's Claws, I don't even know. I don't even know. We're gonna go for Slash. Slash! And destroys her entire team. So, we are finally out of there, and we're in Lavender Town, so... I think with that being said, guys, I think that'll be called an episode. So the question of the day today is favorite gym leader. My favorite gym leader is Sabrina, and after that in Gen 2 it's Morty, but favorite Gen 1 gym leader in Kanto, I like Sabrina. Who's yours? Leave a like if you enjoyed this, subscribe to see more, guys. In the next episode, I will see you all later.